Here is a bulletin from CBS News. In Dallas, Texas, three shots were fired at President Kennedy's motorcade in downtown Dallas. The first reports say that President Kennedy has been seriously wounded by this shooting. From Dallas, Texas, the flash, apparently official, President Kennedy died at 1 p.m. Central Standard Time, 2 o'clock Eastern Standard Time.
My fellow countrymen, on this occasion, the oath I have taken before you and before God is not mine alone, but ours together.
Yes, my name is Doug Rice. This is my accounting of the Vietnam era war. 1968, I was in college and basically didn't even know where Vietnam was or anything else. It wasn't a big thing in small Lee Summit country type town. And one day I dropped one class in college. I was too busy running around, drinking beer and chasing girls. I was working full time at an automotive plant, Chevrolet, and going to school full time, and so I thought I'd drop one class, and that made me eligible for the draft. I didn't know you'd be a full-time student. They didn't care. A week later, I get a draft notice. I wrote deceased on there, sent it back, and next thing I know, the sheriff shows up at my house and found out that I wasn't dead. I hear these Vietnam vets talking about daytime fighting. Well, I don't know where they were fighting, but I was in Central Highlands up in the jungles, and Camp Inari in the Central Highlands near Pleiku was an Army base. I was at the fire base at Con Tum, and you go on patrols, and I hear Vietnam vets talk about shooting every day, and I don't know where they were at, but like I said, you go on patrol and walk all day, clear back till night till you went to sleep, pull a poncho over you, and never fire a weapon. You wouldn't see anybody. But you lay there at night and you keep listening for the enemy. Everybody was scared they're going to die. And you hear a sound turn out. It's a pig running through the grass, which is 10 or 12 foot high. They had boa constrictors, 10, 12 foot long, running through that grass. You think it was the enemy coming. Everything there was scaring you. The guys during the daytime mostly sat around smoking dope, and the rest of us were drinking beer and whiskey, getting ready to go out at night, and then or else you're on perimeter guard. And the Vietnamese, they had a very low value life. They'd send satchel charge people through the wire at night, trying to get in. A lot of the atrocities that took place, they were forced to do. The NVA, regular soldiers, and Viet Cong, they'd kill their whole family if they didn't do things. You could go through on a patrol, a village, you'd find arms hidden down wells, below rice, bags of rice, the food. They hide the weapons there.
Do you have a few artifacts here you might want to show us?
Yeah, this is a...
Where did you get that?
This is one of the unspoken people in Vietnam that I have the most admiration for. There's a mountain yard people. They live in the highlands. The Vietnamese people hated them too. They were treated like blacks were here in this country. Those mountain yard people could glide through that jungle like ghosts or fog. You'd be on patrol, you wake up in the morning, there'd be one of them laying next to you. He came all through the trip wires and flares, and how he got in, you don't know. But he'd be laying there, and he'd be smiling and grinning, and give him some canned sea rice, and he had a friend forever.
What were you doing here in this photo here? Can you hold that up to the camera a little bit?
Oh, this photo here, we were on patrol, and that little stream, as you can see, is about 6 foot wide, but that thing's about 25 or 30 foot deep, the water. Out of those mountains in Vietnam, the rain runs down, it digs those little rivers like that deep.
Apocalypse Now entertainment going on there. That was
the girls that flew in.
That was a base camp for entertainment. They had bands from the Philippines, United States. They had a lot of Red Cross girls. They called them Donut Dollies. They put on shows. They have ESO shows come over. These are the Mountain Yard people. The Indians in the United States buried their people a lot, very similar, on a little platform in the air. The Vietnamese put up a little platform. That's my pack sitting on top there. They put their dead up on there, and that's how they buried them like that. I came back from a base camp, Camp Anari. I'm going back to the field. That was my birthday, going through a Pleiku, Vietnam. I was back in base camp, and I'd got in a fight with a sergeant, and I was a little mad that they weren't going to let us have any beer or anything else. So when late that night, some of my squad was there, we broke into the officer's mess, took all our liquor and all our steaks, and we had a birthday party. And so as punishment, they sent us back to field, but we were going back to field the next day anyway. So it didn't matter. A lot of people didn't even have anything against the Vietnamese. So it's sort of unspoken rule. You didn't fire nobody unless they're getting ready to fire on you or are firing on you. And that concludes everything that I have to say.